Right, I'm going to do a few examples of how to simplify rational expressions. Our steps will be to factor and then cancel any common factors. So here's our first example, and one thing to keep in mind is it is not factored. We have this entire expression, 4x minus 20 and 8x minus 20. So we have to factor both of those. And the first thing you do in factoring is look for a common factor, which is 4 of the numerators. So I've got 4 times x minus 5. And in the denominator, the common factor also happens to be 4. So that will get me 2x, let's see, plus 5. And now I see that the 4s are common. Now, if of course it was 8 over 4, I would cancel and get a 2, but actually both of these cancel, so I can cancel the 4s out. And so my answer here will be x minus 5 over 2x plus 5. You still cannot cancel the 5s. You cannot cancel the x's because remember, x minus 5 is the factor. X is not a factor. 5 is not a factor. It's that whole thing, x minus 5 and 2x plus 5. If you want, you keep parentheses around it or write it the way I have in the box here. All right, here's our second example. Again, notice that neither the numerator or the denominator is factored, okay, because this is one big expression. So I can put parentheses around there to drive that home, but that's not necessary. But we need to factor it. Both of these are trinomials, and you could do this on scratch paper, figuring out what the factors to each of them are. Let's see, to get the x squared, I have to have x and x. And let's say I'm going to have a minus 12, so I'm going to have a plus and a minus. And I'm going to end up with a plus 6 and a minus 2. You might come up with some other way. I'm just kind of doing trial factors. Same thing in the bottom. Not too difficult to factor. X times x is x squared. And I need factors of 12 that add up to 8. So that's going to be plus 6 and plus 2. Now, you should always do the FOIL method to make sure you really do get this original expression. All right, so what cancels this time? Well, x plus 6 is a common factor, so I can cancel this. So my answer is x minus 2 over x plus 2. Again, that's an entire expression, x minus 2. You cannot cancel the x's, you cannot cancel the 2's. You might ask yourself, why not? Imagine if you had 5 minus 2 and 5 plus 2. That's really 3/7, correct? You can't cancel the 5s and say it's negative 2 over 2. You can't cancel the 2s and say it's 5 minus 1 over 5 plus 1. Same thing here with the x minus 2 over x plus 2. All right, here's our third example. We've got 5x minus 16 over 16 minus 5x. Now, neither of those can be factored further, but what you want to notice is that those are opposites. In other words, 5x minus 16, if I want to leave that like that, in the denominator, that's the same as factoring out a negative 1 and having a 5x minus 16. So you don't see it, but there's really a 1 in front. If you could say you could factor out a 1 if you'd like. Right, so the 5x minus 16s cancel, but I get 1 over negative 1, which is to negative 1. This is similar to a problem like 7 over negative 7. If you have opposites, it's negative 1. Here is our fourth example. Again, remember, you have to factor the numerator and the denominator. You cannot cancel before you factor because this is an entire expression in the numerator and in the denominator. So in the numerator, we have a difference of 2 squares. So we could write that way, 5x plus 2 times 5x minus 2. Notice I'm not reminding you how to factor. So if you forget how to factor a difference of two squares, go back and study that. And in the denominator, this happens to be a perfect square. It's 5x plus 2 times 5x plus 2. You might recognize that, or maybe you find out how to factor using some other method. But in any case, I factor the numerator and factor the denominator. And then if there's a common factor, we cancel. And so again, there's our answer, 5x minus 2 over 5x plus 2. Again, we cannot cancel the 5x's, can't cancel the 2's. All right, here's our fifth example. Once again, you can't cancel the 12 and the 9 or the x squares because that's an entire expression. So we need to factor each expression. Now out of the numerator, again, the first thing you do is look to see if there's a common factor. And in fact, there is a common factor of 4x. So I can factor out of 4x. That would give me a 3x minus 1. Now the denominator, there's no common factor, but here we have a difference of two squares again. So it's 3x plus 1 times 3x minus 1. And now we can cancel our common factor, which is 3x minus 1. Get 4x over 3x plus 1. All right, here's our next example. All right, so we're going to factor the numerator. And in the numerator, I see there's a common factor of x, so that's what we're going to do. And in the denominator, there also happens to be a common factor of x. It's the greatest common factor, so I'm going to factor that out. But the denominator is not completely factored. Now if you want, if this is partially factored, so at this point I can cancel the x's, or I can do that later. As long as it's as long as you're canceling common factors, it's partially factored, you could do that. So, or you could wait till the next step. But if I cancel them now, then all I have left in the numerator is x minus 4. And in the denominator, I need to factor x squared plus 3x minus 28, and that happens to be x plus 7 times x minus 4. So I can cancel the x minus 4s. Now notice you don't see anything left in the numerator, but remember there's always a 1. If you don't see any other number, it's not a 0, it's a 1. Because 1 times x minus 4 is still x minus 4, right? Okay, so our answer here, we still have that 1 in the numerator and x plus 7. A lot of people will write that the answer is x plus 7, but remember, x plus 7 is in the denominator, not in the numerator. All right, here's our next example. So again, we need to remember these are entire expressions, it's not factored. Now, the numerator has four terms. I would suggest you kind of do a little bit of scratch work to figure out how to factor that. The denominator is not so hard to factor because we have just the x squared here. So that's x and x. We're going to have plus and minus to get a negative 5, and then you have to figure out where the 5 and 1 goes, and that works out. But the numerator, there's all sorts of ways to factor when you have four terms. We're going to have to use grouping. So we could maybe try grouping the first two terms and the second two terms together, for instance. You can do this because there's a plus here. And then you could take out the common factor of x squared. So that's x minus 1. And the common factor out of the second parentheses is 2, which is another x minus 1. And now I have this common factor of x minus 1 times x squared plus 2. Now, that's not the only way to factor four terms, but that's the method I'm using right now. The point is, you need to factor this numerator, and when you're done factoring, you should have the same factors I have, which is x minus 1 times x squared plus 2. And then, I look to see if there's a common factor I can cancel, and there we go. So we have x squared plus 2 over x plus 5. And there we are. So lots of different examples.